ears. That's why I praise God for the word and be it here. The word became flesh, lived for 30 years. Died at 33, but after days reappeared. Jesus Christ anointed one, ascended in the ear. Or you can say the heir, where the Father made him heir. Of all things, the throne, no, it's more than a chair. But after our redemption, yes, he did take a chair. Greater than the angels, named superior to theirs.
Chapter 1, Mr. Chaos.
I'm leaning to the right. The light is where I'm running. I thought I wanted light, drunk, sexed out and blunted. But all I really wanted was the one who really wanted. Fought death, beat it, gave his life to the public. I love it, I love it.
Hey, hey. Angels surrounding his throne. Where he is,
from the planet Mars. I love to preach Jesus, you can read it in my bar. I'm pretty straight fire when I'm speaking about my Lord. He paid the sin price, being beat by Roman guard. But when he resurrected, gave us life free of charge. Now me and my bud need to be in a psych bar. Cause we went crazy for God, our lives were scarred. Now in the book of life, our names have been written down. We're casting our crowns before his feet on the ground. It's such a holy melody and a heavenly sound. Out of the mouth of the four living creatures by a throne all around. Can you picture the scene? That this is how it's going down. You just need a little faith and a new set of eyes and a telescopic lens to look in and see God. I love you. Like a home run, Christ is King, Lion, Lamb, God, Man, yes. Sin conqueror, grave conqueror, Satan conquered. Yes. Can take a sinner, atheist sinner to God conscious. Yes. Can take nothing, make creation and lives under. The same God that came through a fetus is Jesus. Yes. Limited to breathing, God believers singing.
Joyful, joyful, joyful noise. That's what's up with it, everybody. Hey, listen, listen. Welcome to Fit Fridays with the Truth on Fridays. Listen, I had to had to hit the pedal to the metal. Listen, I keep it real over here, right? I keep it real. Okay, I keep it real. Listen, I had to hit the pedal to the metal. I had to make it do what it do to be here for you. At 8 o'clock, today was about 8:05. So you know I had to make it happen. But guess what? At the end of the day, I am here. And guess what? As always, we about to have a phenomenal whole hour to ourselves. Well, I'm not gonna say a whole hour. Most like it typically goes an hour and a half when it Fit Friday. See, that's why I didn't care about coming late, cause I already know I'm gonna take the show over. Ain't no 9 o'clock cutting it off. It's like 9:10. The producers don't know, man, but I'm slowly increasing in 5 minutes every Friday. You know, so we're gonna be, so eventually we're gonna get to the two hour mark. We get there. We crawling, but we getting there. All right. So again, I want to welcome everybody now, and also when you watch it later on, if you don't have time to watch it, thank you for tuning in, and thank you for watching. And at the end of the day, you're gonna learn some. If you all about health, listen. If you all about health and fitness, you have joined the right show. Again, like I said last Friday, I'm hoping everybody got the Lord praising and all that good stuff and phenomenal stuff out the way. And again, I got to start my show off by saying this. There's nothing without the man above himself. So I got to start that off by saying that first before we get into anything at all. We're going to say and get a man credit where the credit is due, because again, I'm going to say it again. There's nothing else, and it's nothing better than the man above. So again, after all saying all that, we about to get it in over here on Fit Fridays. We're going to talk about health, nutrition, how many push-ups you can do. I want to know how much protein everybody been eating, how much carbs. I came in here, my man was eating some chips today. I peeped that, but I didn't see exactly what it was. I just heard some crunching. Oh, he showed me some other stuff. Now, see, this is funny. He told me he was ready. So we got to talk off the air, man. We got to talk. He don't know it's boot camp season over here. It's boot camp. Like I said, we're going to have people lining up in here. See, eventually I want to take this show where everybody just line up. 8 o'clock, you know. Forget going. We can go live, but all the cameras going to be on everybody. We're doing push-ups. That's what's going to. See, we're going to. This ain't nothing but the beginning here. This ain't nothing but the beginning. But again, I'm hoping everybody had and is having a phenomenal Friday. And I do believe 4th of July is coming up, right? That's that they say, like, this is the weekend for all that stuff. You know, I seen in the news that Midway, all the airports is flooded and all that stuff. You know, they go on travels, safe travels, and whatever you do, be safe out here, because this world is, you know, I'm hoping for the better, but I gotta say, be safe. That's the first priority. All right, so we're gonna kick it off with some good stuff. We're gonna talk about all type of fitness stuff. But right now, we're about to do a quick break. When we come back, you know, like I said, I was running a little late, people. So, you see, look around. I got no laptop. I got my cell phone. But guess what? I didn't forget this. You know what I'm saying? Maybe if I would have been on time, if I wasn't stopping, because there was a couple people in line at me, in front of me. So, listen, I keep it real over here. I can step in and say, I've been here since 7:30. You don't want to die. No. We ain't doing none of that. But other than that, we're going to kick it off with some R. Kelly, World's Greatest, because it's exactly what it is. It's for each and everybody out there who's struggling, who's not struggling, who's successful, who's not successful. And listen, join in, enjoy the music, and I'll be back shortly.
In the country, I am a river down in the valley. Oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Baby, I made it. I'm the world's greatest, and I'm that little bit of hope when my back's against the ropes. I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest. Just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it.
I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope when my back's against the ropes. I can feel it. I'm the world's greatest.
In the wings of life, I'll reign love.
I will reign.
And the world will notice.
Oh, yeah. Don't get me started up in here. Hey, listen, again, thank you for tuning in for Fit Fridays. Now, enough with the talking. We about to get into some goodies. We about to get into the real reason why I am here. Now, we're going to talk about some protein. But first, you check out my last show. You see, you never know what I'm coming with. You never know. But I'm mentioning that because Alicia and Zyra, you know, they are two very, very intelligent females that's on, I mean, they have so much knowledge. I was picking a brain here and there as I was getting to know them, and they have so much information that they're going to be bringing to the table that they can share knowledge on the show. And just in general, we got some big things coming in the making. But I'm mentioning that because that was like a shock to everybody. Listen, I wasn't even ready to be like, okay, let's jump in. But like I said, we had mentioned the topic, and then she was over on the sideline just talking. Even the producer was like, man, you know what? Just we'll set the mic up, put her on, you know. So that wasn't on the basically itinerary, but she has very good knowledge. They both have very good knowledge. And stay tuned, people, because guess what? I'm going to have them both on this bat. We all three of us going to be on this bad boy in a minute, and we're about to shut it down. But nevertheless, we're going to talk about some protein, okay? Because I know everybody know about it, heard about it, or at least seen it, or at least heard somebody talk about protein when it comes to fitness. And why is that so important? And the reason why it's so important is because that's the building blocks for building muscle, okay? Really quick, I want to give a quick shout out to all the people that I'm seeing right now who tuned in. Suzanne Begins, how are you doing? Thank you for tuning in. I'm hoping you have a phenomenal day and your weekend. Julie Norman, she's always there. Lo Harris, she's always there. Suzanne, still listening in Minneapolis. Okay, I appreciate that. Like I said, we lit over here. I'm glad you listening in. We getting it lit. Isn't it? We're getting better and better. Jermaine, James, how you doing? I'm looking at a producer because we're trying to figure something out over here. Sierra Harris, hey Uncle, I'm here. Well, thank you. I'm glad you're here. You know, you need to come to the show. You know, I'm hungry. You guys gonna bring some. I'm not gonna say pizza. That's my weakness, everybody. Pizza is my weakness. I haven't had it in I don't know how long, but I'm just gonna tell you like it is, right? All right, so a quick shout out for everybody who's watching, who's gonna tune in. But like I said, we're talking about protein. Protein is very important. If you don't get anything in your diet, if you're training, listen, and this goes for everybody who's working out, who's trying to build muscle, who's just living a healthy life. It's very important that you get protein, okay? That's the building blocks, how to build muscle and to get in shape in general. Your body needs that. It has all the vitamins and minerals that it needs to help your body recover, okay? So, but there's importance of this. Now, we're going to talk about protein synthesis. Now, some of you may be like, what is protein synthesis? Well, there's a window that is very, very critical that you need to make sure you take in your protein, okay? Now, some of you say, well, as long as I work out, I can take it whenever. Well, that's not necessarily the case. You can, and it still is better to do that than none. However, if you miss this window, it's not optimal. So let me explain some to you. Let's say you go to the gym at 1 o'clock. You do a full 2-hour session. Let's just throw a number out there. You know, now 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. Now, it's 3 o'clock. You're going to leave. Now, there is a study, but there is a rumor going around that says, well, you need to get your protein in about, you know, no later than a half an hour after your workout. That's a no. Okay, that is a myth. It's not necessarily the case of that sort of a window. As long as you get at least 24 to 48 hours, that's when your body is really, really, really needs that protein synthesis and it's heightened. So that means is this. When you get done working out, whatever you put in your body, your body is going to suck it up. It's just like a sponge. So, and that's going along with your protein. So that's why it's very critical that you get that stuff in, you know, to the fast as you can. Now, for me, when I leave, I already have my shake ready because it takes me about a half an hour to get to the house. And I got that already ready to rock and roll. Now, some people may say, oh, I missed that window. Listen, I know some people, they left the gym, you know, they in the car scarfing down all this protein and they wind up throwing it back up because that your body is still trying to calm down from all the strenuous work you try to do. So I'm saying that because I don't want everybody out who's watching this. I don't want anybody to go out there and start doing this type of stuff. It gets out of hand and gets out of control. This is a myth. You don't need to get in as soon as you leave the gym. It's the study is this. Anywhere between 24 to 48 hours that you can get your protein synthesis in is heightened, okay? And that's critical when you can get it in. So don't think when you leave the gym right away you got to do all this crazy stuff and scarf down all this stuff. That's not the case, people, okay? So listen to me when I tell you that because I'm not going to do nothing but show you the right way. Now, that's the best timing, okay? Now, to me personally, the best timing for that is, let's say, about a half an hour tops for me. That's the best timing you want to consume your protein. That means your chicken, your fish, everything that packs protein. Those are the things that, you know, that obviously you want to consume for good amounts and quality protein. Okay, now the best timing, like I said, is about a half an hour. Don't go down this road, like I said before, as you got to do within 5 to 10 minutes before you leave the gym. You're shaking up a shake. You see people do that, right? You see people do that, and this is why I'm here, because it's I was once that person. You know, when you leave the gym, you see me shaking the button, the shaker, leaving up out of there, like, okay, well, I need to get this in right away. No, that's not the case. If you want to go to the house, you know, within 30 minutes to 45 minutes or whatever, you want to get your protein in. I always preach food in general, okay? That's first. Forget all these supplements. Get your food in first, because that's what you can get your results from, okay? So that's the best timing. 30 to 45 minutes, but you don't have to do within 5 minutes when you leave the gym, okay? Now, I want to talk about really quick about fat burners, okay? Now, I'm sure people heard about this before. I'm sure people, you know, they've seen it. They heard about it. It's a little pill form that people take That they say fat burners on there, and you know, all this crazy stuff. Now I mention this because that's another supplement that you need to be careful with, and I'm going to tell you so right now. This is very critical. So if anybody out there watching, listen very carefully, because this can actually harm you more than help you. Okay. So fat burners. If you don't know what fat burners is, you go to your local vitamin shop. And you see fat burners on there, you grab of it, you turn it over, it tells you take one or two daily on an empty stomach or before working out, right? Now, if anybody don't know, fat burners is nothing but a little pill form of caffeine. That's all it is. So right now you see me sitting here, I'm talking to you, I'm doing a computer. If I was to take a fat burner right now, my heart would just start palpitating, because it elevates your heart rate. That's how you actually start to burn fat. Now, I see people, this is where the critical comes in. I see people, they take these fat burners and then they go to the gym and they drink a pre-workout. Okay, now think about this for a second. If you're taking a pill form that elevates your heart, now all of a sudden you're going to go to the gym and you're going to take two, three, all these scoops of pre-workout that's full of what? Caffeine. What you going down a one-way ticket to A, heart issues, I mean, collapsing in the gym, all this crazy stuff. So my point of this is telling you, when you see fat burners, okay, don't think it's a miracle pill. Personally, when it comes to my clients, I don't preach that. I don't preach that first thing, because nothing's going to get you in shape but hard work, dedication, and cardio. And obviously, needless to say, the food, right? So I know a lot of people who strive on this. They take it day in and day out. Now, let me give you a quick tip. Let me give you another quick tip. A lot of people assume that taking a fat burner, they automatically going to start losing weight, right? And they take it daily. A fat burner is needed. Let's say, use me for example. Now, I'm going to be competing September 22nd. Okay. Now, I would say about a week or two tops, I could be start taking that fat burner, doing my cardio just to make sure I burn off the excess fat as much as possible, right? That's the only thing that you should be able to do, that using that type of supplement for. Not taking it every day, thinking it's helping you with your fat loss and things of that nature. Because at the end of the day, like I said, it's nothing but a little caffeine and a little pill, okay? And the last thing you want to do is to take those fat burners and all of a sudden go to the gym and take some pre-workout. But that goes along for Monster, Red Bull, anything else you take. See, these are the type of things your average person just don't know. They see fat burner on there, but they don't necessarily know what's in it. And it can actually hinder you if you start doing some crazy stuff like I just mentioned, okay? So please, use that type of stuff with knowledge and knowing what to do, and not just going off what it says on the label, okay? Please, because at the end of the day, it can hinder you versus help you, okay? So, all right, a lot of talking, because that's some very serious stuff there. But these are the type of things that, you know, that doesn't express enough. I don't really see any kind of trainers really talk about this, but again, the last thing you want to do is overhype your heart. So let me show how critical this is too. Let's say you take a fat burner, your heart rate is elevated. Now you take a pre-workout, now your heart rate is even more elevated. Now you're going to go on the treadmill and start running. Now what are your heart is doing, right? Think about this. I'm planting that seed. Think about this for a second, okay? So we're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we are going to talk about stretching, how important it is, and when it's actually critical to stretch. Let me ask you this. How many people in the gym see a lot of people stretching before they work out? I know I don't see it. But when we come back, we're going to talk about that. And again, if you're here, chime in. I want to hear some comments. We'll be back shortly.
Everybody's got a blank page, a story they're writing today, a wall that they're climbing. You can carry the past on your shoulders, or you can start over. Regrets, no matter what you've gone through, Jesus, He gave it all to save you. He carried the cross on His shoulders, so you can start over.
Don't let your heart be troubled. parted. Their wishes, they never been born, never been torn, never sinned, never disobeyed. I know you think there's no hope,
no,
but that ain't true.
Jesus saves.
I know you feel a regret,
like I
brought this all on myself,
like I
messed it up big time, and this time I don't deserve God's help.
Thinking, how can God forgive me?
After knowing what I hid,
can he?
After knowing that I hid from him and I stayed away and backslid.
Listen,
Jesus came for the sick,
so true. So
Jesus came for the weak,
amen.
Jesus came to give good news and to set the captives free,
amen.
Listen, Jesus came for the poor,
amen.
Jesus came with the keys,
amen.
Jesus came to remove the chains so the prisoners can
be released. Everybody's got a brain fit, a story they're writing today, a wall that they're climbing. Past on your shoulders, you can start over regrets. No matter what you've gone through, Jesus, he gave it all to save you. He carried the cross on his shoulders, so you can start over.
See, his love is deeper than the ocean floor. Run to his arms like an open door. God the Father sent the Son, so men can come and be free. Gotta run no more. Come to me, all who are weary. With heavy burdens, I'll give you rest. Separating you from your sin. As far as the east is from the west. Thrown in a sea of forgetfulness. What sin? What offense? And when them waves come crashing in, now calm the winds in your defense. So whatever it is that you've done, he put that punishment on his Son. You'll never come under his condemnation. Conquer sin and Satan and his accusations. So dry your eyes, lift up your head. Hallelujah! God is not dead. Plus he gave us
his peace,
and he took our guilt on the cross instead. Took our place and now we embrace a clean slate with the eyes of faith.
We do,
unfailing love,
everybody's
it's not too late,
got
start up.
A story they're writing today, a wall that they're climbing. You can carry the past on your shoulders, or you can start over.
All right, all right, all right. And, you know, so this is the thing. This is the thing. You know, again, hoping everybody's having a phenomenal Friday. I know I am. But, you know, last week, you see my show. I'm all about that, you know, excitement, you know, making sure everybody get up out of their seats, having a fun time, motivating, pushing everybody to their next limit. But then you're going to see some times on the show, for me, you'll start seeing some, just sharing some really, really good information. Because it's, for one, it's actually it's very critical. That topic that I just talked about before we broke for air, like I said, it just that's very, very critical. The last thing you want to do is overwork your heart. You want to get your heart up to an elevated state so it help you burn fat. However, you don't want it to overstimulate your heart. Again, this is why people pass out. They feel lightheaded. And listen, let me ask you a question. How many people who have heard or seen or a relative or a friend or a foe that you see them, you talk to them, well, yeah, I was in the gym today. I just felt kind of lightheaded today. I just wasn't myself. Well, think about that for a second. They probably did something on the verge of what I just said. Okay, your body, see, the body is a phenomenal thing. It gives us, for the most part, it gives us warning signs before it starts to take us down that dark road, okay? So when you start feeling lightheaded, not feeling good, queasy, you know, whatever the case may be, you know, those type of things, the telltale sign, something is not right and is giving you a heads up on something, okay? So again, I lost count of how many times people have, like I said, just say, man, I just wasn't feeling good. That was lightheaded, and they jacked up with all this, you know, fat burners and all this other stuff. Okay, so please be safe out there. You want stuff to work with you, not against you, when it comes to that. And like I said, you're gonna get now today's show. We get more. We diving in with knowledge, and what I'm bringing to the table, and not just how much protein I should take. Right. So think about that. So now stretching. All right, everybody, listen up. Pay attention, because now we're going to talk about stretching. Stretching is very, 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 very critical. Now, It doesn't. Some of you may say, "Oh well, you know, only if I'm older, I should be stretching. When I reach a certain age, I should be stretching." I've heard it all. If I'm young, my joints is okay. I shouldn't be stretching. Well, all of that is a myth as well. All of that is a myth as well. It doesn't matter if you're 20, you're 25, you're 19, you're 18, 30, 40, 50. It does not matter. Everybody, if you're going to do some type of resistance type work or even cardio, especially cardio also, you need to make sure you stretch. Quick question. How many of you have seen where they jogging or running and they hamstring pull? They grab their back of their leg. Oh, I got a hamstring pull. 95% of that is because they didn't properly stretch. Okay? Same goes for injuries in the gym when you're weightlifting. You didn't properly stretch. Let me dive down a little more into that. Now, stretching. Before you do anything, cardio, weightlifting, whatever, the first thing you should do walking to the gym, obviously, while you're dropping your bags and stuff off, get a resistance band. Okay? All of the gyms has it nowadays. Get a band. First thing you should do, work your shoulders. Stretch out your shoulders. Go to my YouTube channel, Truth Training, and see the type of tutorials that I have on there. I have a breakdown of everything of when it comes to workouts, stretching, all that stuff, because it's critical, okay, the type of movement that you should be doing. Stretch your shoulders out, because like I said about three shows ago, no matter what you do upper body, your shoulders plays a role in there. If you're going to do arms, if you're going to do chest, if you're going to do back, whatever you're doing, your shoulders play a role in that. And that's the number one common injury in today's world when it comes to fitness is shoulders. So make sure you warm your shoulders up with a weight resistance band. Okay? Do foam rolling. Roll out your thighs. Roll out your hamstrings. Roll out your hips. Roll out your inner thighs. Roll out your glutes. You should be taking about 15, 20 to 25 minutes, literally tops of just stretching. Now, some of you, I get it. Some of you may say, oh, well, you know, I don't have that much time. Well, that's on you. If you rather go into the gym and do this because you just don't have that much time and to avoid injury, I wouldn't recommend that, but it's very, very critical. Okay? So again, it's very important. Now, some of you may ask, before or after the workout? Well, you always want to stretch properly before a workout, not after. Before. Get your body in tune. Wake it up. You know, like right now, I don't care if we've been active all day, it's still a difference going into the gym, start doing weight resistance type of work or cardio. So wake it up. Don't say, oh, I've been active all day and I'm feeling pretty good. I don't need to warm up. Listen, you need to do that first thing off jump, okay? So don't get that in your head like I've been active all day and I don't have to do that. No, you should do that every time you before you work out. Every time, okay? And basically what I want to talk about is the importance of that. Now, hamstrings, I touched on that. Hamstrings, that gets pulled. Rotator cuffs, that gets, you know, that right away, that gets torn. You can be out 6 months to a year if you tear a rotator cuff. I don't know if anybody know that. 6 months to a year. Okay, and then when you come back to a year, that doesn't mean you're going to be back where you left off at. It's going to take you that much time also to get back on track where you came from. So again, it's very critical to stretch, people. Very critical. Okay. Also, really quick, we talked about protein, we talked about all that good stuff. I know I touched base on carbs before, but I want to touch a little bit more about that because it's very critical. I had a couple people reach out to me about, well, should I take protein and carbs just around the same amount of grams before bed, during the day, all that good stuff? Listen, carbs is fuel for the body. That's what it is. It's carbohydrates, right? So the last thing you want to do is before you go to bed is to eat all these carbs, okay? Now listen, this is a very, very, very good tip. I love using examples. I worked out late yesterday. I came home like about 10:30 at night. I was down a meal. So the first thing I did, I grabbed something that was high in protein, low in carbs, low in fat. Okay, I don't need carbs for before I go to bed. You know, I don't plan on doing jumping jacks in my sleep. You see what I'm saying? So listen to what I'm saying. This is basic science, people. This is not rocket science. It's basic, okay? That what I'm giving you, that people just lack so much of. I just know a lot of people who drink all these carbs or eat all these carbs before bed, and then they wonder why they can't get their body, their stomach and their body fat down. Listen, if you don't burn off the carbs, it turns into what? Fat, okay? So if you consume all these carbs before bedtime and you lay down on it, okay, and you're not burning it off, it will turn into fat. And I know a lot of people do this day in and day out until they meet me, until I get them on a regimen, and then they start to trim down a little bit. All because I tweaked their carbs. Okay, so carbs is good for you, but can also be bad for you. Okay, so remember that. Now, we are about to go on one more break. Before we do, we're going to talk a little bit more about stretching, and we're going to talk about basically what I got coming to the table. Now, this is, you know, beneficial for everybody who's watching out there in the Chicagoland area that I want to share with everybody if you happen to get in some type of training. So stay tuned. All right. So like I said, everybody, you know, before you start going out, you know, having fun, having a few cocktails, which, man, I've been doing a lot. So I'm thinking tonight I'm going to go ahead and give me some a little bit of red wine. How's that sound? You know, but hence what I said. There ain't no beer. No, we not doing none of that. All right. We about to do some protein. That's all we're going to be doing over here. All right. Again, thank you for tuning in for Fit Fridays with the Truth. My name is Antonio Norman, whoever did not know. And on every Friday, I bring to you good knowledge, good way of living, safety living, and just all around ball of just living a healthy lifestyle. Whether if you're trying to lose weight, gain muscle, whatever, I cover the whole globe. Now, I want to touch a little. I want to talk about one of my topics from last show, last Friday, that me and another personal trainer, she goes by the name of Alicia, and we was talking about how to spot a bad trainer or good trainer. We cover both topics. And we actually stayed on this for a while when it comes to personal trainers who actually don't look the par in trying to train others. Okay, now, you know, if you could still have a lot of knowledge up here, and I know a lot of people who's like that, who have a ton of knowledge, but their physical appearance, it's just not, you know, they're just not up to par for whatever reason. Now, I'm not talking about natural causes, anything like that. People get sick. Listen, first things first is get well, right? But I mean people who just don't care, you know, eat burgers all day and, you know, you call yourself a personal trainer. I'm a firm believer, like I said before, it's just, you know, the proof is in the pudding, you know, the writing is on the wall type deal. You know, that should be first, right? So if you're going to preach and tell somebody to do this many push-ups, this many, you know, sit-ups, you know, I'm a firm believer of, you know, you should be able to back that up as well. And that's just, and I'm just being honest, you know, you should be able to back that up as well. If the person you're training can outwork you, how come you're a personal trainer, right? It's just, I don't know. But like I said, we didn't mean anything by it. We just kind of like just wanted to tell the truth out there. I just wanted to just classify that and cover that topic, you know. So if anybody out there who's need to lose a little bit of weight, you know, truthinresultstraining.com, you can always find me there. My plans, if you just want some basic knowledge on just you follow some training, you can go to my YouTube channel. That's Truth Training at YouTube. And just follow me all over social media, Instagram, Truth In Results Training as well. And this is what I do full time. Now, quick little shout out to a couple of people. I see some people tuned in that I may didn't see. Adlai, what's up, Adlai, my man? How you doing? Good seeing you again. Got to come back over to the house, man. It was good seeing you again. Thanks for watching. Your family love you. Thanks, son. You give best advice about protein. How many bottles of protein can I drink per day? That is a very, very, very good question. 50. Using 50 cans and bottles. I gotta keep a little. I got to, right? No. All right. So if you're talking about those regular drinks that I recommended you, that's a very good brand. Personally, each of those is contained 26 grams of protein for your body type. I know how much you weigh. Two per day. Once when you get up, once before bed. Solid. That's all you need to do. So you don't have to worry about drinking multiples a day. Once in the morning on an empty stomach, first thing in the morning, before your breakfast or after your breakfast, and also before bedtime. So you can have that in your system while you sleep. So that was a good question. Really quick. Now, for anybody who's listening out there, good stuff coming your way. If anybody in the Chicagoland area, I currently have two gyms under my belt now. Actually, one studio and one gym that I'm starting to personal train out of. I will be sharing all that information with everybody shortly. But one is on the south side, and then one is actually in Beverly off of 95th and Western. And I also have another one on the north side around Wrigley Field. So that way I can cover both areas. The one on the south side, I'm going to be doing some type of group training. So it's going to be cardio and conditioning. So if anybody interested in cardio and conditioning, I'm going to be start sharing some information along that on my shows. So if anybody interested, please hit me up here or call into the show, you know, bug the producer, you know, he my man too. Say, hey, listen, where's that group training at? You know, I'm sure he has sent me all the information that's needed. I have not been promoting it at all, because I want to make sure I found a good location for everybody, good parking, good location. So no one's going to travel a whole bunch away. So I'm dipping my hands in that too. If anybody want group training or one-on-one training, okay. But like I said, I'm gonna start sharing information with everybody shortly, okay. Also, really quick, you know what? Let me talk about something really quick. It's what my mom mentioned. She mentioned about protein drinks. Okay, so listen, that's a good question. For those of you who's interested in getting those big tubs of protein, and you say to yourself, well, I don't know how much I should take. Now, listen, first thing first, if you're trying to live a healthy life, or if you're just trying to, let's say, build muscle, whatever, first thing you should do is a gram per pound of body weight. For example, let's say you take an average 160-pound guy, right? You should be consuming, your first priority should be 160 grams of protein, period. No more, no less. That's how you should start off. I know a lot of people don't know that, but whatever the case may be, if you eat a lot of protein as far as fish, chicken, all that good stuff, track that stuff. Track it, because at the end of the day, you'll know how much you consume. If you got to back up one last one to hit your numbers, protein shake before you go to bed, do it. But that's one of the main reasons why it's critical for you to track all your proteins, your carbs and fats, all that, because you know where you at and leveled out. So a gram per pound per body weight for protein. Okay, again, if you weigh 170, 180, that's around the time or around the how much you should be consuming each day. Okay, because I've gotten a lot of people about that before. Okay. So really quick. So now, for those who didn't quite understand where I was coming from about the fat burners, is this. We're talking about your health. We're talking about living a healthy life, right? And not getting sick and not feeling lightheaded. Supplements is supposed to be for tools in the gym. Use them as tools, not everyday use. These fat burners is number one prime example. Okay, so if you're getting ready for a show, if you're getting ready to do something that you know that you need to drain all that water out, you need to sweat it out, get your heart rate up, whatever, that's the time to plug in those type of supplements, like fat burners. Again, whatever you do, don't take these things day in and day out. Now, I know for a fact when you buy some, you're going to flip it over. It's going to tell you 2-3 a day, daily. Take them all the time. Well, unfortunately, that's a supplement company is trying to sell you product, okay? The faster you can run out of it, the more you can go back and you can purchase it. But I'm telling you what works, and not giving you some type of heart issues or whatever, okay? You don't want to take that stuff every single day. Listen, I know people who take those first thing in the morning, and they down a whole bunch of coffee, like... That's way too much caffeine, and you don't need that in your system, okay? So that's very critical for everybody who's out there watching, okay? So please, be safe, and don't listen to what your average guru is trying to tell you to try to sell a product, okay? So really quick. Now, I'm competing, right? September 22nd is my show. Now, one major thing that I'm focusing on is my meals. Even if you're not even competing, your meals is critical. Know what you're going to eat. You need to know this, because if you don't, at the end of the day, you're going to fall down that road of, again, fast food, things of that nature. I know what I'm going to be eating more each day. That is a quick tip, again, for any and everybody who's just lost, that don't know how to... you know, where to start when it comes to meals. But I want to touch on that really quick. So we're going to go on a last break before we go really quick. I got to go on a break really quick. So when we get back, we're going to talk a little bit more about what you should do if you're just trying to live a healthy life versus someone who's just trying to gain muscle, lean, or get low body fat percentage. Just maintain a healthy life. We're going to touch on that when we get back.
I've been waiting on, and my soul is overflowing with anxieties and expectations full of desires. Oh, I just want it so bad, you know, and it just seems so real.
reach out and touch it for what all disappears. Sometimes it feels like everything is passing me by. Every now and then it feels alive. My ship has gone and sailed away, but I gotta be strong. Gotta hold on. It won't be too long.
Now the tide is coming in, I see the waves flowing out there on the ocean. I know my ship is coming in, just past the horizon, and right where the sky ends.
Out there on the ocean, I know my ship is coming in, so don't leave me hanging. I've been waiting too long for this moment. My ship has finally come. I will travel to the seven seas.
I will even go.
I will even go. It's like fighting with gravity, and it's bringing me down. If this world is really round, then tell me how. It's just enough for you to come around now.
Now the tide is coming in, I see the waves flowing out there on the ocean. I know my ship is coming in. Just past the horizon, and
right
where the sky ends.
South there on the ocean, I know my ship is coming in, so don't leave me hanging. I've been waiting too long for this moment. My ship has finally come. Yeah.
Finally.
All right. So listen, if anybody out there who's interested in personal training, I know I don't do this. I don't do this enough because I'm busy and I want no services. No, I'm kidding. Listen, I'm gonna come with a funny joke all the time. That's what I do. I'm busy. I don't want no services. What businessmen say that, right? So I'm gonna plug it in right now. And this is for all the viewers out there right now who's watching this. This is strictly for you. So if anybody didn't tune in, maybe they can catch it next time. But this is strictly for the people who's watching. If you go to my website, I got everything linked on Facebook. If not, go to my website, truthinresultstraining.com. That's truthinresultstraining, okay? Enter discount code 20. Okay, if you're interested in any type of personal training online or anything like that, just go to check out my webpage and see what I have to offer. Enter code 20. That's 20% off of whatever it is, even if you just want a meal plan. Okay, a customized meal plan for you. And what that is a strict customized meal plan that's strictly that you can download from any type of mobile device. So if you're on a go, if you're in the gym, You can download it to your any mobile device, and you can go step by step of what you can do to eat healthy and live a healthy life. Whatever the case may be, if you just want a truth hat, I got those on the websites as well. Again, enter code 20. This is all for the viewers on here to get 20% off on the website, okay? Sometime you'll see me plugging in my apparel, my official apparel line. That's teamresultsapparel.com, teamresultsapparel. Again, this is strictly for all the viewers here who watch this. Enter code results. That's going to give you 30% off of the entire website. If you want a hat, if you want a shirt, if you want whatever the case may be, it's high quality gym apparel, 30% off. Again, if anybody didn't listen to the show, I've been telling everybody, you should tune in. You should tune in because you're going to miss a lot. It's only in the beginning. Okay. Now, I was kidding when I first got on the show. I'm like, okay, I'm getting, you know, 10 minutes every after every show. If anybody listening, like, this guy's still in time for my man. I got to go and talk to him. No, I'm not doing that. It was a joke. But not it is 9 o'clock, and I cannot be on here wasting time like this. Atlee, what's so? Just say my man, I'm glad I seen this before I cut off. Hey, cuz, this is one of my guys. Oh, okay, you supporting your boy. I like that, Atlee. I tell you what, when you call me, man, I'll help you out if you're looking for some any type of training, nutrition, whatever. I got you, cuz that's what family do. All right, so I am not going to stay on this thing for 9:30, 9:45, even though I want to. I'm just going to be honest with you. You don't want to. But I am not. So again, visit all of my websites, Truth and Results Training, Team Results Apparel. Okay. Now, I want to tell everybody something really quick. If last show or this show, if you're enjoying these shows on Fit Fridays, every Friday, 8 p.m., I suggest you tune in next week. Next week is probably going to be the best show on Fit Fridays as of yet. I mean, it may be the best show on TabernacleRadio.org, right? You never know. You never know. But I just know what I got cooking on the back end, and I got some stuff coming for you next Friday. So if you happen to tune in and see this, make sure you join me next Friday, 8 p.m. Central Time, all the way to 9, not 9:30, not 9:30, okay? All right, enjoy your weekend. Have a safe and a blessed weekend. And as always, I'm bringing to you Fit Friday with the Truth. And I'll talk to everybody later.